Hi everyone, it's Gregor here again, and in this short video I'm going to show you how to tag your Azure resources automatically using Azure Policy. So let's get started. Okay, so let's get started by opening up Chrome, and let's browse to the Azure portal. Okay, now that we're in the Azure portal, let's take a look at our subscription, and then we'll take a look at resource groups. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a brand new resource group just for this Azure Policy video. So I'm going to click on Create. And then I'm going to click in here and give it a resource group name. I'm going to select the West Europe region. And I'm not going to give any tags. I'm just going to set up a blank resource group. So that's validation passed. Just click on Create. Okay, that's done. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a storage account. So I'm going to click on Add and then go to the Marketplace. And then I'm going to scroll down and choose Storage Account. Then I'm going to put it in the resource group that we created. I'm going to give a storage account name. I'm going to give the region of West Europe. It's going to go for standard. And for redundancy, I'm going to choose locally redundant storage. Click on advanced. It's going to leave everything as is. I'm not going to tag this. And then I'm just going to click review and create. So no tags whatsoever. So now that the validation's passed, let's just click Create. Okay, so that's going to go off and create a storage account. That should take not very long, should take a few seconds at the most. Let's just wait on that getting done. Okay, so now that's done, let's click on Go to Resource. So here we can see our storage account and we have no tags. So what I'm going to do now is add an Azure policy, and I'm going to set an Azure policy to automatically tag resources in this resource group. So if I go back to my resource group, so I'm in the resource group and I'm going to go over to the left here under settings and choose policies. Okay, and then I'm going to take a look, and so far so good. My resource groups are both matching the compliance of the policy that's already in place. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to assign a new policy to this resource group. So let's click on Assign Policy. And then I'm going to choose the policy definition over here. So under Basics, I'm going to go down to Policy Definition and I'm going to click on the three dots or the ellipsis. So this is going to load all of the different available definitions, and I'm going to type, I'm going to search for Add a Tag to Resources, okay? So I'm going to click on that, I click Select. And then I'm going to click on Parameters, which is the second part at the top here. I'm going to give it a tag name. So the tag name is basically what's the tag name and a value, so it's like a key value pair. So I'm going to call this Environment. And then I'm going to give the tag value of Production. So the idea here is, any resources that I add to this resource group are going to be tagged with environment as the name and value as production. So that's how we automatically tag Azure resources. So I'm just going to click on review and create and then click create. So it's going to go off and it's now doing it. So it's already done. Now normally this takes about half an hour to basically add in the policies. So that's why you can see add a tag to resources. The compliance state is not started. Give that half an hour. Come back in half an hour and roughly that'll be done. But we don't really need to do that. So what we'll do now is we'll create another storage account, and this time we won't add any tagging, and hopefully the policy will kick in, well, it will kick in, and it'll automatically add the tags to the resources. So let's go back to home. Let's go back to the resource group. So we're in the same resource group. Let's create another storage account. Let's go to the marketplace. I'm going to click create on storage account. We'll choose the correct resource group because that's what the policies apply to. So the scoping of the policy is applied to the resource group in this instance. So now I need to give it a storage account name. Let's call it whatever. I'm going to put it in West Europe as well. I'm going to change it to locally redundant storage. I'm going to click on next. Next, next, next. I'm not going to put any tags in, and I'm just going to click review and create once the validation's passed. So the validation's now passed. Let's click on create. So I haven't added tags here, but what will happen is this time the Azure policy is in place on the resource group and it will automatically add a tag with the name, environment, and the value of production. So let's just wait a few seconds on this happening. So this is how you automatically tag resources in a resource group. That's what this demo is showing you how to do. Okay, so that's done. Let's go to the resource. So we're in the storage account, and there you go. You can see that it's automatically tagged. So that's basically how you automatically tag resources. So you can tag them with things like cost center values, department codes, things like that. And that'll help with billing as well. So if you tag your resources, which I highly, highly recommend you do, this can automatically tag the resources for you, depending on where you put them. So you might have environment production, you might have environment test or development, things like that. So I'm pretty sure you catch the drift of this. So thank you for watching. Hopefully you'll hit the subscribe button in the bottom right hand corner of this video and give it a thumbs up and a like. And please check back for more videos coming soon. Thank you.